So Mrs. Phelps is the librarian that has a mobile library that Matilda visits because, as we know, her parents are, they're not big book people. And she meets her there. She's the adult in the movie that Matilda connects with without any baggage. I mean, I'm not saying Mrs. Phelps doesn't have baggage. She's got great baggage, but with the kid, she has no baggage. So she's a very important adult in Matilda's life, and I think Matilda talks about her experience of her life through the stories she tells Mrs. Phelps.
I know you've spoken before about the impact that books and that world had on you and your life. Can you tell us a little bit about what it meant for you and why this story resonates with you as much as it does?
I was bullied in school because I was from another place, and I didn't like to go out in the playground because you always got into trouble with the other kids. So there was a teacher, Mrs. Tun Shin. She was from Thailand. And she let me stay in and read books. And that really mattered to me because I could have a great time but not be out getting bullied in the playground. So I loved that. And she had a real capacity to connect with me. And she made me feel like my interests were important. And, you know, it's easy to ignore children. I really liked her.
Roald Dahl is one of our most beloved and celebrated storytellers. Can you talk about why his stories, that often tend to be quite dark in places and quite genuinely perilous, seem to resonate and connect with us on such an important level?
I think being a child can often be very scary. Every child is at some level helpless. And his stories, they don't shy away from that, but there's a way of making that come right. And I think the child in us, everyone has felt scared as a child at some point. And Roald Dahl says yes, and then he fixes it. What else do you want?
And for people who have not experienced the stage version, can you talk about musically what makes this such a beautiful piece?
The songs are, you won't forget them once you hear them. The children perform them so beautifully. And the songs are very meaningful, but they're fun. You know, they're not like so deep that you're like, oh, what is this about? They're fun and they're meaningful and they're performed so well. I mean, you know those jokes where you're like, you had to have been there? You have to have watched it and then it'll be great.
And obviously there are a few characters in literature more terrifying than the Trunchbull. Can you talk about what made our beloved national treasure, Emma Thompson, the right person to play that part?
I think Emma's great because she has such great empathy with children. And she sees children. And I think she also embodied the grief and the hurt and the pain that Trunchbull had in her. So she really humanized her. And I think that was very special.